Wednesday, the 26th of May. We are leaving Joplin, Missouri, and headed to St. Louis,
Missouri.
Road conditions are dry, and the sky is gray. They're expecting some, rainy weather this afternoon in Joplin, so hopefully we will beat that storm and get out in front of it and just have smooth, clear roads ahead of us. What are you expecting today, babe?
I'm expecting to go from a 70-degree day to an 87-degree day in St. Louis, and possibly drying trend before sunset so the humidity knocks off and be nice, because I would love to take a walk. We're staying only a few blocks from the Gateway Arch. It would be nice to walk the dog if it's not oppressively hot.
It would be nice, and I think he would enjoy getting out. He's not had many opportunities this trip for walks.
Put my shorts on and bring out my pasty white Northwest legs. but otherwise, expecting not a whole lot of traffic today. Any traffic is more than what we were getting for the last few days. We're seeing trucks on the highway now, and more travelers. In the last couple of hotels, business travelers in Kansas City, it looked like just people taking trips. Here in Joplin, people stopping on the way from there to somewhere in their van or in their minivan, and then a couple of looks like business folks traveling.
The hotel offered a food gathering last night, which we opted to skip.
And burgers
and it's probably chips or something. Was that all included in the hotel, or?
Yeah, the residence inns will do that. They'll have gatherings for the week, depending on where you are. Here, it's burgers and fries. If you're in California, it'll be a wine with stuff. Depending where you are, it might just be nuts and cheese. So, depends on, how many folks they have in and how many repeat guests they tend to get.
Let's continue.
We're going to stay at the, go to the free tours at the Precious Moments Factory.
No, we can skip that.
Can we skip that? Okay.
Yeah.
Trying to think what other sites might be on the road today. Now the Gateway Arch, I think, is the big one.
Okay.
Other than that, today we should get rest areas. Yesterday, surprisingly, between Kansas City and Joplin, it's nearly 200 miles and no rest areas. So I was thinking, when we were coming into Kansas City, we saw the sign, last rest area in Missouri, that maybe it was just that highway.
It really meant it.
No, it really meant it. Well, when you continue all the way to the border, you're not going to get another rest area.
Let's just say we got to our destination a little bit faster than we'd planned to.
Yeah, it was an interesting ride. Maybe it's got a lot of fun. No.
I do not.
But today we can rest areas. How's the dog doing?
Looks like he is falling asleep. He tore his wound open last night, and
which
it
one?
Was the wound on his right foot, the new one, and it was bleeding pretty bad. So he's got a new bandage on it with some medication. We've ordered more medication to be delivered to not the next hotel, but the one after that. It just takes time to get there. So I will make do with what we have. But unfortunately, he's got to wear the cone in the car because he is just picking at it like crazy. And got to get this under control. So he's not feeling well, which makes me not feel well, which makes William not feel well. So we're having a little bit of a go with that.
Time is 8:01 a.m.
8:01, we are on the road, have a good start, and ready for the day.
unexpected stop. Not for the chocolate, not for the clean restrooms. Don't believe that. I can't take a road trip with Amy and not pull off the world's largest gift store. We will post a review. How do you get there from here?
I think you go that way.
Okay.
Yeah. And then we turn
in. Over Redmond's. Not Rednecks, but Redmond's. Okay.
I might get lost in
here. You're at a candy factory or at the gift shop?
Oh, gift shop. Who cares about candy?
They don't open for another 15 minutes.
Oh, dude, we can't wait around for 15 minutes.
Yeah, we can wait. We got places. We didn't get up for 5 o'clock this morning, so we got time.
Okay. All right.
That was and is apparently the world's largest gift shop. And if I gifted you anything from there, maybe you should feel special that we stopped here, and that's the only reason that's a special gift. Otherwise, it's just a tchotchke store.
Yeah, it was a little disappointing.
We should have stopped over there.
At the candy factory. Well, I expected to find something a little more central to where we're located, or, I mean, they did have a little bit of the Route 66 stuff, but nothing for the state, nothing really. I mean, it was just like going into a store that had pajama bottoms and puzzles.
Take the next right onto Pine Street.
It really wasn't anything special. I was able to purchase a hot pad for the table for Thanksgiving. It has some really pretty pumpkins on it. And I was able to purchase a tiny trinket birthday gift for my best friend. So
merge onto I-44.
It wasn't a complete loss, but we don't recommend it for a stop if you're looking for something that's local or has the name of the state or something like that.
They had the entire Bob Ross booth.
Well, they had a lot of interesting things, but most of it was
three racks
like
of coffee mugs,
tchotchke.
Things about Bob Ross. Bob Ross with the chia pet on his head.
I almost got the salt and pepper shakers with the chickens. Those were spectacular, and I know my friend Rhonda would love those, but I didn't have any extra space in the car for anything quite that large, so I didn't get them.
All right, world's largest gift shop, Phillipsburg, Missouri on I-44, between nowhere and somewhere. Got room 706 at the St. Louis Hotel, autographed by Marriott. Hotel St. Louis. Corner suite with windows, black marble floor, closet. What can you tell us about the bathroom, Amy?
Bathroom is very large. There is a television in the mirror, and there is also a bathtub inside the shower area.
Let's step in. Care to step in with me? I'm going to bring the rest of the football team with you.
It's certainly spacious. Interesting sink layout with the water spilling down and headed back towards the back.
I believe we've got some amenities here. That is a scale on the floor. I do like the sink. Apparently we have a wavelet bidet on the toilet.
A gorgeous full-length mirror, although it will be a bit difficult to properly use it. A chandelier above the bed.
Ooh, that's nice.
The wall of windows, which are closed for now because it's very warm outside.
The cone of shame on the dog.
The beautiful room.
Is this a wardrobe or is there something else in here?
It is not. There's a refrigerator and a coffee bar. And then I'll also place the dog's leash.
And in theory, a light. But yeah. Is there anything in the fridge or is it?
I haven't opened it. I don't know.
So is that a mini bar or is that just a fridge? Just a fridge. Nice touch.
Plenty of storage space. Looks like a nice comfortable bed, a place for you to work, a nice television, a sitting reading area. Very luxurious.
And the close of this video is the next stage. Still giving us paw issues.